in your way.
Allowed something else. Maybe God this, and maybe God, and maybe some of our thoughts of God need to go by the wayside. That really aren't about God, but about what we think God should do. But you will follow God if you keep the faith. And maybe some of us need to get the faith back. Dream again. Because we don't want to dream again because it's going to mean you might not get what you want. It's not about you. Families as a church, we need to come together and honestly and intentionally work at what is most important. And it's relationships, a relationship with God, second, relationships that He's called us to build and nurture. Everything else. Still of the opinion that if I had 100 people that had this kind of heart, we could take this count for Jesus. I believe that. That's what I'm looking for.
We were almost there once. And the enemy came in and destroyed.
That happens to a lot of churches, man. I know it.
But you know what? God builds out of ashes. God restores and strengthens. He puts the foundation still there.
Also second, it's about a relationship with God and a relationship with each other. Everything else is after that. It's keeping things simple, keeping first things first. What do you want? It's not what you need. Yeah, I need to pray. Yeah, I need to read the Bible. Yeah, I need fellowship. I need to worship. God to work on your water. Because in that passage in Philippians that we looked at last week right before it, Paul says, I want to know Christ. He didn't say, I need to know Christ. Everybody needs to know Him. I want to know Christ and the power of his resurrections and the fellowship of sharing in his suffering. I want. God, put that in our hearts that we would want that. Do what you got to do to make us your people. In Jesus' name.
Worshiping, getting back into worshiping, back into listening to worship music and soapy music and just different types that I used to listen to all the time. It's funny, it's not so funny, but when I came in here this morning, Ron said, you're a whole lot different than you had been before, and usually when I come in here, I'm not in a real good way, spiritually.
We call it spiritually, you're in a snit.
I'm in a snit most of the time, on Sunday mornings, when I come to practice.